Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Our today's lab is about band arithmetics. We will see what is actually band arithmetic in remote sensing, and we will perform band arithmetics in ADAS Imagine and in QGIS as well. QGIS is open source software, freely available, and we will analyze the output image we got from ADAS or QGIS using the metadata. And then we will be finally concluding our lab. So the first section, what is band arithmetics in remote sensing? Band arithmetics is simply addition, subtraction, division, or multiplication of two bands. For example, we have already an idea that we have a band named as NIR, near infrared band, and a band named as red band. So dividing near infrared with red, right, the output image, it will have vegetation enhanced, right? So we can use division operation to enhance certain features. Similarly, we can subtract two bands, we can add two bands, and we can divide two bands. So this is the method of this is the advantage basically of using band arithmetics. Now, performing band arithmetics in ADAS Imagine, we will use the model maker. We already have done a lab previously about ADAS model maker, in which we made a simple and complex model. So the first step, what we have to do is to open the ADAS Imagine. We have to add our layer. I have data over here, for example, Kola Ichnos image. I will add it up over here. Now this is an image. It has four different bands, so we can change the band combination from here to enhance certain features, right? So here buildings, trees, vegetation, river, or water body. So there are many features. Now what I have to do is to go to the toolbox. In the toolbox section, now in the toolbox section we have model maker. We just have to click this icon, model maker. It will take a couple of seconds to open. Now here we have the interface of model maker. We have covered basics of model maker, and we have made a complex and a simple model in one of our previous lab. You can see that. So we have to input our raster image, we have to define our function and output image, input, function and output. Connect this with this icon arrow. Here you have to define your input image, that is Kola Ichnos. You have to declare it as float because we are performing some ratioing techniques now. Now here I want to divide my fourth band with my third band. For example, in vegetation studies, vegetation has a maximum response in NIR, minimum response in red band. So you can divide near infrared with red and specify your output in some folder and name it as simple ratio, and click OK. Here you have to declare your float output as float double and click OK and just execute this. So this is a way you can go on with band arithmetics. Now important thing to note down in band arithmetics is you have to define your function. Now here we have the output ready. Here we have the simple ratio image. Now this simple ratio image is basically a ratio of near infrared with red, and you can see that this part, that is the vegetation, right? So we can use inquire, or we can define some threshold based on this. Now similarly, what you have to do is to replace this division sign with the addition sign, so you will get an addition of two bands. Similarly, you can use the subtraction sign, and you can also multiply the two bands. using this. So this is the band arithmetics in ADAS Imagine and how to perform it, right? Now the next phase of this lab is to perform the same in QGIS. So you have to start your software QGIS, which is an open source software. We will add our image there and perform band arithmetics in QGIS. Now in QGIS, we have to add our layer. We have to go to the layer section, add layer and add the raster layer. In add raster layer, you have to specify your data and click add button. Once you click the add button, this window will appear. The next thing you have to do is to go to the processing toolbox, and in toolbox you have to select the raster calculator. In the raster calculator, you have to define your operation, that is band 4 divided by band 3. The next thing you have to do is to specify the cell size. For example, I am using 30 meter by 30 meter cell size. And next is the define the extent. Extent I am setting use the layer extent, that is Cola Ichnos extent. Output CRS, that is default. The next thing you have to do is to save this to the file. For example, I want to save it here as an output data. Just click save, and once you click save, just you have to run this process. Once the process has been run successfully, you will have some output image like this, right? So it will be similar to what we have performed in ADAS Imagine. So using QGIS, we can perform the band arithmetic. Similarly, you can perform addition, subtraction, division and multiplication. Thank you. That's all for today's lab.